Hi, we are from Group 1, Subgroup 1, and we would like to present high solids anaerobic digestion for the recovery of energy from municipal solid waste. The objectives of this research are to recover energy from vegetable waste by subjecting them to high solids anaerobic digestion, to utilize the inherent advantages of high solids digesters, and to compare the performance efficiency of three different types of high solids digesters.
In this experiment, there are few materials involved, such as MSW that was collected in the form of vegetable waste from the trash bins of student hostel of Pondicherry University, and then three different types of digesters, namely as HSD1, HSD2, and HSD3. In the table shown were the characteristics that can be identified through the three digesters. The differences of each digester can be seen through the chamber or unit and volume and diameter. For the method, MSW was collected from the trash bin of the student's hostel of Pondicherry University and then chopped to 2-3 cm long before feeding into the digester. Inoculum was prepared by mixing 1:4 ratio of the effluent slurry from a cow dung fed by gas digester with double distilled water, and the mixture was stirred, settled for 4 hours, decanted or poured and filtered. The digester was operated with acclimation and startup period for 6 weeks. 31 g of fresh weight MSW and 250 ml inoculum per liter of digester volume were put into the digester. Acclimation is important to provide a stable anaerobic digestion of organic fraction of MSW. Digesters were left to acclimatize for 3 weeks after 3 chargings. At the time, bioreactions that reached the digester bottoms was recirculated from the top. Digesters were fed with 100 g MSW per liter once every week for 4 consecutive weeks after completing 6 weeks of process. 1 out of 3 of the solids from each digester were then withdrawn to enable resumption of the feeding of fresh MSW. Meanwhile, in another set of experiments, anaerobic digestion performance was enhanced, where HSD1 was equipped with biofilm support system or BSS to its lower compartments.
Operated digester fed with fresh leaf or assorted species in batch mode had achieved loading rate which equivalent to 0.21 g and 0.28 g total solid per liter of digester volume per day respectively, and biogas yield 0.053 and 0.068 liters per liter of digester volume respectively. Different types of agro residues in the undried solid form digested to obtain biogas yield ranging from 0.2 to 0.5 liters per liter of digester volume at solid retention time spanning 7 to 10 weeks. Recently, semi-continuous operation and much higher loading rates and gas output per unit digester volume have been achieved. As we can observe from the table 1, the average weekly biogas production followed the orders of HSD3 greater than HSD1 greater than HSD2. HSD3 had 2 independent vessels for the digestion of the solid and the liquid phases. HSD1 had 2 compartments for the same purpose, while HSD2 had no provision for the phase separation. From figure 3, there was further enhancement in the biogas yield in the former types of digester when HSD1 was run with and without biofilm support system. The efficiency of HSD3, however, even without biofilm support system, was the highest, and this appears to be preferable reactor configuration for high solid digestion of municipal solid waste. The result of the study indicate that the performance efficiency in terms of biogas yield of the high solid digester increased with the increase in the degree of separation of solid from the liquid. The high solid digester design with separate solid and liquid phase unit HSD3 produced more biogas at 179 per liter of digester volume per day compared to HSD1 produced 820 per liter of digester per day, which compartment design within single vessel separated the phases, and HSD2 with no phase separation provision produced 630 per liter of digester volume per day.
So after 8 weeks, the digester efficiency has been reached, especially with HSD1 and HSD2, as they are unsaturated digester with a heterogeneous feed. Therefore, this degree of quality is remarkable. Secondly, HSD3, HSD1, and HSD2 were the weekly order for the average weekly biogas output, and the extension to which liquids, bioleachates, they were isolated from the solid phases and can be fermented in a separated compartment due to the compaction partial digestion for the solid food. There's another experiment when HSD1 was used with and without biofilm support system, BSS. The biogas yield in the previous form of the digester was further increased. However, the efficiency of HSD3 without BSS was the highest and seems to be the preferred reactor setup fast MSW digestion. Since this is anaerobic biomass fermentation, there's two primary stages, and the acid process consists of two acidic acetogenic phases, and those two steps contains bacteria. However, acetic acid converts by a group of methanogenic bacteria in the methane system into methane and carbon dioxide, and this process is actually aerobic. Methanogen are very sensitive than acidic phase bacteria to a variation in pH, feed levels, temperature, and toxicants. Lastly, the efficiency of methanogenesis is improved through the separation and fermentation between bioleachates and other solids, as in HSD1 and HSD3, while methanogenesis often occurs in the solid feed compartment unit of the digester. The dose of substrate is much more reliable, anaerobic, and easier to feed. And now we move on to conclusion.
From the results of this research, there are three conclusions that can be made. 1. Degree of solid separation from liquids affect the performance efficiency of high solids digesters. This can be seen from high solids digesters 3, which yielded more biogas compared to high solids digesters 2, as it was designed with separate units for solid and liquid phase. 2. The use of biofilm support systems can improve the performance of the digesters. Statistically, high solids digesters with biofilm support systems showed a significant improvement over the non-biofilm support systems high solids digesters at 99% confidence level. 3. The high solids digesters have better performance compared to other solid-state digesters. This is due to the configuration of the digester and semi-continuous mode of operation, which allowed for significantly higher versus loading rates and improved biogas yields.
What are the benefits of anaerobic digestion? First, it saves on processing times and costs because the digester is fed directly with solid waste without processing the waste into a slurry as in conventional digester. Secondly, enable the handling of higher volatile solids concentration per unit digester volume. Thirdly, yield a high amount of biogas which can be further utilized to generate electricity, heat for transportation, and fuel. Fourthly, HSD3 and HSD1 has separated compartments for solid and liquid phase digestion. This enables enhancement of energy recovery of the overall of anaerobic digestion. And lastly, small size of anaerobic digestion plants which results in less footprint. We move on to the limitations of anaerobic digestion. The first limitation is the efficiency of anaerobic digestion. This causes problems when the volatile solids content of digester feed increases beyond the limit. The efficiency of volatile solid conversion will drop. Secondly, problems in mass transfer due to the solid feed tend to clog the digester, which prevents the attainment of steady state conditions. Thirdly, different microbes are used in different degradation steps, which require different environment, especially in the methanogens in the methane phase, are very sensitive to the presence of free oxygen, fluctuation in pH, temperature, feed concentration, and toxicants. And the fourth limitation is the need for pre-sorting step to remove unsuitable compounds for anaerobic digestion, such as bone from food waste, disinfectant, pesticides, soil, and wood waste. What are the suggestions for anaerobic digestion of MSW? There are several pre-treatments to enhance biogas production. Physical pre-treatment is the reduction of feedstock particle size to increase the surface area for rapid digestion by microbes. Chemical pre-treatment is used to destruct the organic compound for higher hydrolysis rate. Next is biological pretreatment to reduce the volatile solid concentration, and thermal pretreatment for cell membrane disintegration, which then leads to the solubilization of organic compounds. The second suggestion is to upgrade the plants for further utilization of biogas and digestate, such as biogas storage and converting digestate into biofertilizer. These are the references that we use in this presentation. And thank you for listening.